In this video, I will show you how to sum numbers by month in Excel like this. So let's get started. I have some transactions with dates and amounts in this Excel sheet. Now I want to calculate the total amount by month. For example, for the month of February, I want to sum these two amounts, and for the month of March, I want to get the sum of these three amounts. We can use the Excel SUMIFS function to sum numbers by month. The SUMIFS function returns the sum of the values in a range that meets multiple criteria. We can specify more than one pair of range and criteria using this function. To start with, I will enter the first day of 2 months, that is 1st January 2024 and 1st February 2024 manually in these cells. Since I want the sum of numbers for the first 4 months, I will select the first two dates and then drag it till the month of April. Now let's format these cells so that only the month name is displayed instead of the full date. To do that, select all these cells and then press the Ctrl and 1 keys on the keyboard to open up the Format Cells dialog box. Now select the Custom option from the left side. Delete everything from the Type text box and then type MMMM as the format to display the dates as the full month text. Click the OK button to close the dialog box. To get the sum by months, I will find transactions having dates greater than or equal to the first day of the month and less than the first day of the next month to get the total amount for a particular month. Since we already have the first day of each month, I will use the Excel EDATE function to add 1 month to it to get the first day of the next month. Let's type an equal sign in the target cell to start the formula. Now type SUMIFS followed by an opening bracket. Since we want to add the amount cells for the month, I will select the range of the cells containing the amount as the first argument. Now we need to specify two pairs of criteria range and the criteria. Let's select the range of the cells containing dates as the first criteria range. Type a comma and then type the greater than or equal to sign in the double quotes. Type the ampersand sign and then select the cell containing the date of the first day of the month. Type a comma and then select the range of the cells containing dates as the second criteria range. Type a comma and then type the less than sign followed by the ampersand sign. I will use the Excel EDATE function to add 1 month to the first day of the current month to get the first day of the next month like this. Type the closing bracket of the SUMIFS function. Overall, this formula means sum all the cells of the amount range where the transaction date is greater than or equal to the first day of the specified month and less than the first day of the next month. Hit the Enter key to complete the formula. Copy the formula to other cells by dragging the cell down from the bottom right corner of the cell. As you can see, Excel has automatically increased the amount and date range references. That is because these ranges are specified as relative ranges. Let's make the amount and date ranges absolute using the dollar signs like this. Leave the month reference as relative because we want to increase it when we drag the formula. Now, when we drag the formula, these ranges will stay the same without any change. As you can see, we now have the sum of the numbers by month. Watch these videos for more Excel tips, tricks, and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.